invoking divine energy always. Yes. And yes, the first topic that we will be talking about is divine guides. Somehow in our lives, we are always guided, whether we recognize it or not, acknowledge it or not, believe it or not. Do you feel so? Do you all feel that you have a divine guide or you don't believe in it? What is it?
Believe.
I believe, right? Yeah, yes, there are different, there are different people we believe. There are people, there could be a physical guru in our lives who's always guiding us, maybe a teacher, maybe a religious guru. Or there could be some saints here or a god, whatever. We all believe in that, isn't it? Somewhere, yeah, somehow we all believe in that. Now, the important thing is, but then, what do the divine guides do? When do they help us and how do they help us? Because we believe that we have problems, we pray to something or someone and we expect our divine guide to help us. But they, all the time it doesn't happen. We wonder, why when I'm having such a hard time, when I'm praying and I'm looking out for answers, and why is nobody there to help me, isn't it? It happens to us, isn't it? We are like really desperate and things don't move the way we want to. So there is a simple, because basically we understand about divine guide, but then why it is not happening? There are three reasons that you have to understand. Is that one, you have your karmas. We all now understand that we have reincarnated beings. Over the eons, we have come again and again to this earth. And we have developed certain way of living and we have developed karmas because of that. So one is that it is part of the karma. We have only planned this lifetime and come and brought those karmas with us. If you are working on that, then a divine guide will not interfere, but may help you or guide you in the right direction. But it will not make your karma disappear. You have to work and nullify it. Right? Second part of this is that the divine guide, you are here, you, each one of us has a purpose. But in a whole, this, the way we live, we tend to lose our vision of why we are really on this earth and what we are really supposed to do. So that life purpose eludes us. We really don't know. Again, the guide will help us when we are serving that purpose. If you are moving away from it, your life becomes tougher, in fact. So that also has to, we need to ask this question to ourselves as to why, in spite of doing good or the right thing, why am I having a problem? Sometimes we keep on working with the same thing, but it's not really working for us. Isn't that a sign that this is not my path? Mm. Isn't it? So that time the divine guide in effect take you away from it rather than towards it, because you're not serving that purpose. As simple as that. And the third part, which is the most important actually, that we all have a free will. A free will not allow us to even call upon the guides. We think we can manage it. We can somehow work our way to it, or we can control the situation, you know. If you have a free will which is so powerful that you will not ask the guide, or even if the guide gives you the answers or some direction, we still feel that we are not sure. We still want to work our way and control that also what the guide sends us. So in all these three respects, what happens is the guide is not able to be clearly help you to help you find a way to work your way through the problems. So first thing is that you have to believe, of course, that you have a divine guide. Of course, now people say, I don't know my divine guide. How do I connect? There are nowadays, of course, people who do Akashic records and tarot card readings, and they help you find your divine guides. But even if you don't know your divine guide, it is perfectly all right. But believe you me that you always have three at a time in your life. Now, one couple of them are there from your birth only, but as you're growing and your path is changing all the time, you have a guide at that point of time always. Even if you don't know, you can, with deep gratitude, great respect and immense love, always call upon them that I am facing this situation. Please kindly help me with this problem that I'm facing. Guide me, send some signs, symbols, and you will see it does happen. Suddenly you meet someone or call, someone calls you up and you will see, oh, why? I really, how come I never thought of that? Or how did this happen? something intervenes in your life and guides you in that direction. Now, of course, there are guides who people think of numbers. You see the constantly the same numbers again and again, like, you know, like some people see 1, 2, 3, 4, someone said 12, 12, and then, you know, 75, 84. They'll keep on seeing certain numbers again and again. The Google, the net is filled with the guides of what to make of those numbers. And you will see if you really get the right, if you want, I can send a couple of links which seems to be authentic to me. So the numbers are there. Then there are colors you see. Colors are, of course, the seven rays. You can easily connect it to a ray of, if you see a constantly same color coming in front of you all the time, especially feathers. Feathers are, of course, part of the angels. They always say that the feathers are a real indication that there's an angel around you. You know, so feathers, some people even see some colored stones. The stone has some meaning for that. It's endless. Suddenly you see something, some word coming up to you again and again, or some song, you may not have heard it for a long time, but it pops in your head or you keep hearing that, you know, or you're watching TV and something keeps popping up, or you see a newspaper magazine, that same word or a sentence or something keeps coming up. So these are all signs that the guide is trying to get in touch with you, show you your path, help you, you know, work your way around it, like, so that you can accordingly check it out. Or what is it really trying to tell you? Now that important part is that how do you connect to the guide? If you have a guide and you believe in it, then how do you connect to the guide? Of course, one way is through meditation. If you're meditating on a regular basis, then your vibrations always go high. When the frequency is high and you're able to connect to the subtle energy, you can always call up to your guides. The guide who's around me right here, right now, please kindly, you can share your problem. First, always say thank you for your very presence and I need your guidance or your help. Whatever your problem is, it could be anything. It could be of a relationship, your work, financial issues, anything. You can ask directly, clearly, with absolute humbleness that please guide me. And don't think of things. Like what happens, many a times we start thinking of our own solutions in our head. Then the guide is not able to download that to you. So you have to be calm. Even if the thoughts come, just let it come and pass. Just be an observer. Don't catch on to it and think further. So then suddenly as you're sitting there quietly, it will take a little time. It's not that easy, but just somehow some thought, something comes to you at that point of time. Or you sleep over it and then you, next day morning when you get up, it happens that, oh, you know, I could do this. Or maybe I should call up that person. You know, it sort of comes to you. So one way is to really reach out to your guide by asking their presence to come and really help you. Important thing is, as I said, that when you ask for the guidance, be patient and listen. Yeah, don't think your own thoughts. Now, another thing is that you have to trust that also. That whoever is, now there could be anybody, it could be an angel. There are like supposed to be 72 archangels, and then there are various gods that we believe in, you know, the devas. There are so many across the globe. The ascended masters like Jesus Christ and Mother Mary, and you have Buddha, and there's so many, like. So we really don't know who is really guiding you at the moment or who you believe in. You can even call up to the one that you believe in. Frankly speaking, it's not that it has to be someone, you know, unknown to you. You can add, because they're all connected. So if you're not sure of the guide, or if you don't know whom you really can call out to, if you know someone, if you believe in, you have faith in, you can even do it with that person. I mean, sorry, with that spirit guide. Okay, you can call out to them. You can, with faith, with trust, and with gratitude, share your problem. Wait for that to download to you. Listen in your heart and then see what comes across. Okay. The meditation to some extent is important. You can just be quiet for 5-10 minutes and call out to your guide. It is perfectly all right. In fact, they are waiting. They are waiting for human beings to really, you know, reach to them. They are willing to help. They want to help. But unfortunately, it's we who always think that we'll manage somehow, and okay, thank you, I need your help, and then we forget about that, you know. We don't really wait for them to communicate with us. And they are waiting. Because of your free will, they will not interfere. So you have to let that free will work for you in that direction that you can connect with them and wait for their guidance. All of us rather have psychic abilities. It's not that we don't. Is that is dormant in most of us. And somebody can hear things easily, somebody can see things easily, somebody can smell easily, somebody the thoughts, the intuitive, they just know what's going to happen. So believe that you have a psychic ability, and through any psychic ability, the guide can actually help you with. It's you have to develop the ability, but believe you me, over the time when you start, then you feel it. Oh, I think I can hear easily. Or somebody just spoke to me in my ear, you know. Somebody feels, oh, they saw something. They're a clairvoyant, but of course, clairvoyant is not that easy to be. But hearing things or seeing things, or even a particular perfume or something, you know, you can feel it in your aura. Something has touched you, somebody has touched you, and it's a nice feeling. It is always, all these psychic abilities are actually an extension of your five senses. Five senses on a physical level. Psychic abilities go beyond that. Yeah, so you may know all about this, or I'm just chatting with you in a way. One is listening. There are times that many people have expressed, even in fact, surprisingly, even people who don't generally write, you know, when they after meditation and they're calling out to the guide, they actually sit, you can actually sit with a pen and paper without thinking that you are got to do anything with that. And they just start writing. They're not thinking about it, what they are going to write. The pen just moves. And don't try to read it, correct it, edit it at all. Just write your way. And it happens that, you know, people have written certain guidance from their guides directly, and oh, okay. I mean, it's an amazing thing, you know. If you can develop that writing, people call it auto-writing, where they allow the guides to, you know, make them write. I mean, there are like H.P. Blavatsky was well known in theosophy for writing through the Akashic records with the help of her masters. But even in a day-to-day level, many people are already doing that, auto-writing or writing generally, I would call it as, you know, with the help of the guides. And of course, you must ask for a sign, because it is important. We are not well-versed with this, with the spiritual guides. So always ask for a sign. Give me a proper clear-cut sign. Something that I can follow it in my, to move forward, you know, to solve an issue or to find some kind of a direction or maybe an opportunity to move forward, maybe for a job or a career, a financial problem. Whether it's in a relationship, we do have tough times. Some people, we love them, but we still have problems with them. So you must ask for a sign. Otherwise, how will they communicate? You have to be clear with that. Ask for a sign, pay attention, and beforehand only tell them, thank you, I receive it. I receive the guidance, your support, your help, and wish, and surely will integrate it in my way of being. Automatically, then that sign is clear to you and you can use it well. And you can also ask for your spirit guide for the name. If you wish to know whoever at that point of time is guiding you through that meditation, you can even ask. But I don't know how successful it is in one go. You have to really try many a times to get around that. So, okay. Then I can tell you one the simple thing that you have to remember, that guides, they will never interfere unless you ask them. It is the universal law that they will not interfere till the time they are asked. So you have to, because it is your free will that comes in the way. It is your decision to call for a guide, to ask their help and support, and patiently wait for the answers to come through. And you have to believe first and foremost that what you're doing is so. Just because you can't see anything tangible, that means it's not true. Because there is a far bigger realm than a physical world. And we really don't know anything about it, rather, if you really go to see. So you have to trust and have faith in yourself, and that you yourself are a divine being. And you have to believe that you're connecting to another divine being, which is not on a physical level, but in a spiritual realm. And they are all there. They actually, the most important thing, the guides know what is your soul purpose. They know your, your print, your blueprint of your life. So they know exactly what is you're meant to do in this life, and what you're going through is in tune with that or not, isn't it? So they know, in fact, what are you all about? So when you ask for help, they also keep that in mind whilst helping you as to what you are here for and what you are meant to do. And are you in tune with that or not, or how to push you? So it's important to remember that. So till the time you don't allow yourself to connect, they will not do that. And once they do that, they are just waiting. People say, how can you keep on? It's like begging or asking. Like, frankly speaking, it is not. It is, we are interconnected. We are here to help each other. Whatever realm you are on, we are all one. We are all connected. So it is just natural. If you can ask on a physical level, when you have a problem, you ask a friend, isn't it? Or a family member. So it's something similar. If you're connected, then if we need to grow, one can't be down in the other one up. So they are always trying to help you rise up. Best way is to connect with them, isn't it? The divine guides, and you would be surprised. This is just something that I'm sharing at this point, maybe not elaborate on that. But all the divine guides of any kind, whether they are archangels or there are gods, in fact, we think of gods, we also know they always have their twin flame with them. Like a simple thing, if you think of Archangel Gabriel, he has a twin flame called Hope. You have Archangel Michael, who has a twin flame of faith. So when you talk of hope and faith, you're actually always connecting to them. Do you know that? Because they are twin flames of those archangels. When you think of Vishnu, you think of Lakshmi. When you think of Mahesh, you think of Parvati, isn't it? So there are always twin flames. When you talk about financial crisis, you think for Lakshmi, isn't it? It comes so easily. You may not even pray to Vishnu so easily, but you have a financial crisis, you think of Lakshmi, definitely. So it's on a day-to-day basis when we actually are talking about situations, and when you talk about hope, faith, guidance, you actually bring out these words who are the twin flames of these guides. Ascended masters, gods, devas, archangels, angels, anybody you call it. You know? So keep that in mind now, that when next time when you read up about these archangels or anybody, you'll be, if you read it carefully, of course you have to be very careful with the sites you choose, because there are many people, because of earning money through advertising, they actually pick up certain things and they create a blog or a site, and then they put the same matter, but they're not authentic sites. So you have to take care of what sites also you're looking into. Okay. But if you really look up to the proper sites, you will really see the archangels, and you will read all the history about them, what they're doing now on the spiritual realm at this juncture of evolution that we are in. You'll be surprised to learn so many things about that and what their twin flames are doing, you know, like how we have other people walking along with us with their help and with their blessings, and we really don't know. There are more people than just humans on this earth, actually speaking. But that is again another tangent we'll be going off to. So, but you have to believe that there are people walking amongst us who are here to help us to grow. We have, over the centuries or eons or lifetimes, we are into evolution, but now the time has come that now we have to go for involution. Evolution is a subtle energy coming down to experience gross matter, which is in the physical realm, right? Now, involution, what we are trying to do now, awareness is the first step for involution now. The involution is now the gross matter, which is in the physical realm, now going up to experience the subtle energy. Now what we are into is that now we are trying to go back to the source through all these methods. That's why this cosmic wave is helping all of us to be realized. How come 10, 20 years back people were not aware? They were just busy with leading the normal life. How come suddenly in the last 20 years we all want to be spiritual, know something, do something, isn't it? This is the cosmic wave which is touching down the earth at this juncture and allowing each one of us to be aware so that we can now be prepared, prepare ourselves for involution.